warm welcome to Alexandra Karova!
Alright, give it up to the comics who went on tonight. Good job, everybody!
Good job!
Starting with Jim Ryan. He comes up here, he complains about how unattractive he is. He doesn't tell you about the gorgeous, wealthy girlfriend that just supported him. Because that would ruin the comedy cachet of, oh, I'm such a loser. He doesn't want you to know that, because that would let you know there's a wealthy woman supporting you, and she's gorgeous, and she's rich, and you think you're ugly. That means you're great in the sack. Women! Don't feel bad for comics when they bomb. It just means their personal life is way too good. Yeah. That's what I always kill. Anyway, okay. Praise the Lord. Anyway, gosh. And then there was an Esther Kay said, she said, Steinberg. She said that her dad just wants her to be successful so she could put him in a film in a bit part. You guys, that's the reason they have kids. Right? Like, I didn't think there was one. And now I'm like, yeah, come on! Get to work! Give me a part! Right now! Anyway. God, you guys, we should adopt, like, as a group or something. Be successful! I can play the lady in the ice cream store. The grumpy one. Oh. That acts like life passerby. Anyway, okay. She's really angry. So, God. And then, well, lots of good stuff tonight. Have you ever had your hair look gorgeous and there's no hot guy to see it? You wonder, did it really happen? Right? And if a tree falls in the forest and there's no one there to hear it, did it make a sound? Right? Doesn't count if there's not a hot guy! I don't care! Why is it? It's always when my hair is all wetted down and I look all menopausal sweaty. Even though I'm not even in menopause yet, okay? I bled like a week ago! Anyway, okay, so I swear! Anyway, I'll bring the tampon! No, anyway, you know you're getting older when you start to brag about having your beard. I still can! Anyway, you can stick it in. We can have a retard. Okay, anyway. Yeah, that's what my mom tells me. Your eggs aren't good at your age. They come out, you know. Mentally challenged. But the mentally challenged ones are the most beloved in the family. Sort of mixed signals there, don't you think? And also looking at me like I'm the mentally challenged. Anyway, okay. So I had this day yesterday where my hair looked freaking great, right? And I was at home for a, don't mean to brag, but a Vons delivery. Because that's how lazy I am. There's a heat wave in the valley and I want 10 crates of bottled water. And some other stuff, because I feel like a old lady that can't lift water bottles up 2 flights of stairs, so come on, Vons. Anyway, so, you know, I open the door, my hair looks gorgeous, and the delivery guy is hot.
Woo! Nice.
So I know Jesus is real. Right? Usually they're not. Usually I have to hide my natural beauty. Try to not let it shine. I know it's hard. You can imagine. But and he has the best attitude. Usually people hate my order because it's all water bottles and they got to carry it back and forth in the hot valley sun. And they hate me for that. But he was just Mr. Good Attitude. And I'm like, okay, put most of the groceries over here and, you know, stack the other ones on top of the fridge. I'll help you do it. Because I'm such a people pleaser that even though I'm paying for it, I'm like trying to make it not too hard for them. And And so he's doing that, and I realized when I was turning around and he was handing me crates of 24 water bottles and I was putting them on my fridge, that I'd make these sounds like, ugh, ugh. Sometimes fat people make accidental sex sounds. And I was thinking, oh no, what if he's getting turned on by this? Because, you know, sometimes guys have mistaken my fat breathing for heavy. You know what it's like. Any of you have had a weight issue where you're like, ah, and they're like, what, are you masturbating? No, I'm just breathing. Anyway, so and one of the times, like, his arm brushed mine, and I was like, oh, did he feel that? Because there was a little bit of electricity there. But I just, you know, I'm a nice lady, so I just went on, like, I didn't notice it, and I'm being nice to him. And then the rest of the groceries, where he was supposed to put it in the other area, and I would carry it to the kitchen, he started to naturally carry it over to the kitchen without me telling him to do it. Do you know what that's like when a boyfriend... Okay, maybe I'm jumping the gun here, calling him my boyfriend. You see, you can't fall in love at first sight. Not true in LA. It happens all the time. Anyway, you gotta fall in love where you can. Anyway, so he started to put stuff intuitively where he knew I wanted without me having to ask. Aww. That's like a guy who knows how to rub your clit without you going, wait, rub my clit first. wait, no, I'm not ready yet. You gotta suckle my tits a little more. Okay, anyway. I'm not ready yet. He would like intuitively just get in my cues, you know, I didn't have to tell him. Anyway. So I'm going deeper and deeper, right? And, what happened? So basically, I said, you know, I haven't had a delivery in a long time. Okay, I didn't say it like that, but I said, metaphor. I haven't had a delivery in a long time, but I'm going to get them more often because you were so nice. Might be a little bit of a floozy there. I don't know. Anyway. So, and he said to me, so nice. He said, well, you know, you better try to make that water last. He let me go. Yeah, he was like, that was his way of saying, please don't make me deliver to you again. I hate this delivery. Oh, you're feeling bad for me. You guys are nice. You guys are nice that you actually thought this was gonna be my husband. Anyway, so, okay. Anyway, that's what you want when you're doing comedy. You want people to like cry and feel sorry. Anyway, okay. So that's the thing I'm going for. So he left and I realized that it was over, and I remember the last time I had a cute delivery guy, 18 years ago, pink dot. Yeah. This hot, well, Leonardo DiCaprio looking guy from Russia. It was my own little Russia with Lovskis. And he comes to the door holding the bags, and he fell down, like, I don't know what I'm doing, I know this. I was like, oh, you're my next project. I mean, boyfriend. Anyway. And I fell in love. And I kept, like, ordering for Pink Dot. Never was I to find him again. And I've kept ordering since then, hoping. Yeah, few and far between, right? Few and far between. So the moral of this story, people, is maybe I fall in love too quickly. You know, maybe I do. But don't blame it on me. Blame it on the valley. Blame it on the valley, because it is the porn capital of the world. Oh, if you've ever seen porn, people who don't even know each other fall in love rather quickly. It's like they see each other, this delivery guy, she knows he's the one, and they start trying to make a baby. Because they don't even use birth control. They're just doing it, right? She has no time to like call the clinic and get the pills or get her diaphragm in or have her put a condom on. They just start doing it. And sometimes she meets 8 guys and she wants to have their baby. And sometimes there's 2 guys and they want to have a baby. But that's called adoption. Anyway. So with that, this is called LA Love. That's what this set is called. And I just want to say, God bless you all. Good night. Thank you.